In this video, we're going to be creating a new Ruby on Rails 7 application, and we're going to use Bootstrap as the default CSS framework. So how we do this in Ruby on Rails 7 is a little bit different from how we did in previous versions of Ruby on Rails. So previously, we would have to go through this entire process of installing a gem or including a link to the CDN version of the scripts that we need. However, in Ruby on Rails 7, we can actually do this from the command line when we are creating a new application. Before we get into that, make sure to take advantage of the Skillshare Premium 30-day full access using the link in the description below. So you can access unlimited courses for a full 30 days, including my own Ruby on Rails 6 course, which is on the website. So make sure to use that code and take advantage of that in the description below. So let's get back into the video. When we create a new Ruby on Rails 7 app, we have the option of specifying what CSS framework that we want to use, and that's how we're going to set this up in this video. One thing to note before we create the application is that we want to make sure that we're using the right version of Ruby. So in this case, I'm using Ruby Version Manager, and you've probably seen me in a previous video talking about this. We can use Ruby Version Manager to specify the version of Ruby that we are running when we create our application. So in this case, I'm going to list the known versions of Ruby that I have installed. And you can see the default one is 2.7.3. So RVM use 3.0.0. So I've run that same command again now. And we can see we've got this version of Ruby loaded. One thing I could do here is to create a new gem set for this test application or this test Ruby on Rails 7 app. And what we'll do is use Ruby Version Manager to do that. So Ruby gem set create, call this test app. So this just means that any gems that we install as part of this Rails 7 app, they are all contained within this gem set. So now the next thing we can do is use a Rails new, and I want to show this help. I'll pass in the help option here just to give you an idea of what we can use here. So what options are available to us? So my screen is a little bit small here. Let me just make this bigger so you can see it. So if we look at the CSS frameworks, so we have this option to choose a CSS framework or processor as I've labeled it here. So we can use Tailwind, Bootstrap, and a number of other options here. So whichever one you prefer to work with, in this case for this video, I want to show just using Bootstrap, but you can also use Tailwind if you prefer that too. So let's clear the screen, and I'm going to create a new application based on the CSS framework. So we'll say CSS, and that will be Bootstrap. So now when we do this, it will configure Bootstrap for our application. Of course, we need to give our Rails new application a name. So in this case, I'll just call it test app. So this is installing all of the gems into the new gem set that we created at the beginning of the video. So one of the nice things about installing your CSS framework in this way is that it removes a lot of the problems that you may encounter when you add it to a new application. So this is something that a lot of people have experienced in Ruby on Rails 6 when they add Bootstrap or when they add Tailwind, that there are some issues linking up the style sheets. When we installed Bootstrap and Tailwind in Ruby on Rails 6, the common way to do it was using Webpacker. And installing Bootstrap or Tailwind in this way can lead to a number of problems, especially when it comes to linking up your style sheet. So in Ruby on Rails 6, when you were using SCSS files, it would have to compile it into CSS files before it gets uploaded to the server. So when you push to production, you're actually pushing a compiled version of the style sheet. And part of the issue there was linking of that style sheet from the NPM node modules. So it is quite tricky in the way that it was set up in the previous version of Rails, but I think in this version it is a little bit more simple because it handles a lot of these issues for you. So the installation is finished now, and what I'm going to do is open this up in our code editor. So let's clear the screen. And now we want to open this up in our code editor. So first of all, let's open that directory. So once we open this up in our code editor, we can have a look at what's been done for us. So we've got the new application set up. And if we have a look in here, let's have a look and see what we've got. So we've got our, so have a look in these package.json. In the package.json, let me see if I can hide this a little bit. So you can see I've got Bootstrap installed here as part of the dependencies. So under this JSON, package.json for the dependencies, we can see I've got Bootstrap. We've also got SAS installed, and we've got the Hotwire default packages installed. So if you look here at the bottom under scripts, we can see that we've got this build CSS. So this script, from what I understand, is just running this build to include Bootstrap. So that will be included as part of the application.css once it is compiled. And you can see there's an option here for no source map and load path equals node modules. So now let's have a look at our assets directory. So there should be something in here that includes the style sheet. So again, we've got this import bootstrap slash SCSS slash bootstrap. So this is basically taking this out of the node modules directory. So if we actually went in and look in the node modules, we can probably find this CSS file that's being imported, or this SCSS file that's been imported, whatever it is. So if we look here, we'll see the node modules. And if we open that up, and we go down, let's have a look. Let's look for Bootstrap. So that's under SCSS. Okay. So we don't really need to look in here at all, but I'm just curious to see how this is being. Okay, so now what is happening is it's importing all of these separate partial files that includes all of these components and layout functionality for Bootstrap. So all of this is getting imported and built into one single file. So you could actually go and have a look at these if you wanted, but we don't really need to do that. But the point here is really that it just simplifies all of this stuff by including the option when you're installing or when you're setting up a new Rails 7 application. So we didn't have this luxury in Rails 5 or Rails 6. So this just takes a lot of the effort and a lot of work out of getting up and running with a new CSS framework. So you could go ahead and test this further. So if I run the application now, and if just to make sure that this is working correctly. So in here on the application.html.erb, so that's the default layout that will be loaded once we open this in our browser. So in here, I could just, you know, go ahead and create a default container class. So that's like the top level layout class for Bootstrap. And then I could say class equals row class equals column. So this will give it like a 12 layout or a 12 column layout. So rather than the page being the entire width, like from end to end, this would limit the max width of the page. And it's an easy way for us to see that this is working. Okay, let's move this across. And maybe this isn't the easiest way to see if this is working because I've got this default page. But let's load a custom page here. So this default one is the default route. So let's look at the controllers. We have a application controller. And you know, I could just put in a default. This isn't normally, normally you would create a new controller to do this, but I could just go default home, just create a new route. And then that would give me a new folder in here. Let's call this application home.html.erb. And if I wanted to make that work, then I would just change the routes in here. So you set the route as the default route, which is like this. I have an example here. I think I called that home. So let's reload the page. So you can see now that you know, we've got this max width to this column layout. So we can see now that the page is loading and we've got this new view that I've created. It's like an example here. So what's happening is this is actually already working for Bootstrap. So we've got the layout, you know, it's got this max width on the layout. And you could test this further if you wanted to. So you could simply come back into this. Well, let's just do a quick example here. I could just create this as a, give this a button of success. And reload the page. And you'll see I've got this kind of Bootstrap button. So that's a very quick example of how to set up Bootstrap in your new application, your new Ruby on Rails 7 application. And in the same way, you could have just easily done Tailwind here. So you'd change that value that you're passing in when you create the new app. So you'd just say it's Tailwind instead, and then you would simply be able to come in and use the classes for Tailwind. So that's about it for this video. Just a really short, quick one on how to set up Bootstrap in a new Ruby on Rails 7 application. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you all in the next video.